sucks. Okay, folks, finally I'm live. Yeah, as the title suggests, I will be playing in round 5 of the Lonewolf Under 1800 tournament, a 30 plus 30 classical game, and I think it will be safe just to throw a message into the chat. So I will just turn off the replay so I don't choke my my stream, because that might very well go flat on my face. So it's about 8 minutes until the game starts. My opponent is already online. I sort of think he's probably going to play a blitz game or two, maybe to just work himself into shape. And I think I'll just solve a couple of tactics, or fail solving a couple of tactics. My opponent will probably pop in soon. For a challenge. I guess I better turn the sound off on my phone, because as soon as that one starts chattering, then I might get into a bit of trouble. Okay, let's see. Next tactic. What in the world am I going to do here? I'm pretty sure that I'm supposed to win some material here. Okay, I should have taken with. No. that case, I don't have the slightest idea what is the solution. Yeah, okay, I tried that, but somehow it just failed. Okay, let's see. Okay, I'll just accept the challenge. Okay, so having exchanged a couple of messages with my opponent, I think we are ready to go. Okay, so here we go. The Caro Kann. Okay. I can't say I expected that, but he has been playing a variety of openings. So this is the most principled move. Okay, d5. I think I'll go for the knight c3 variation. I like that line best because the push variation, it leads to all kinds of weird stuff. He takes on e4. Let's take back. Okay. Queen to e2. I wonder if he will fall into a trap or if he'll just play sensible moves. Maybe this wasn't such a good move, but I think it was actually a quite a poor move because he can take my pawn on d4. I wonder if he spots it or if he dares, because he's probably thinking, okay, this is a stupid trap and it might not be such a good idea to take. But let's see how it goes. Okay, that was the principled move, and I have no option. I have to play f3 because if I don't, then this piece is off the board quite quickly. And do I have anything in the form of a surprise in the position? Of course, I should have played knight f3 first. But no, I couldn't have done that either because then my knight would be dead. Yeah. This is the only move. This was to be expected, so c3, just get this queen out of the center of the board. This is sort of like a Scandi setup he has now. So what to do? Let's just start developing. This is he did not fall into the trap, which is quite nasty actually, because after queen e2, if he had played a principled move like knight to d7, then he would be in for a rather rude awakening with a checkmate on d6. So my opponent, he quite naturally just moves his bishop out of the way because he wants to hold on to his light squared bishop. Maybe I should just call for a queen trade. Because if he takes, then I take back with a tempo because I'm developing. And I can castle quite fast afterwards. He takes, and the natural thing to do is just to take back. it's just a question of which way I want to move my king. Okay. He develops his kingside knight. So, I think I will just castle queenside. I am slightly ahead in development, but nothing to write home about. He can catch up really quickly because all he needs to do is move a couple of pieces and castle, and everything will be hunky-dory for him. So let's see what he does here. Bishop to c4. I think I will hold on to my bishop here if at all possible, because if the position opens enough, then I have plenty of compensation for the pawn that I blundered away on move 3 or 4. No, coffee cup is empty. Some fisherman's friend here. It is quite annoying that this light squared bishop is throwing that spear through my defense, so I think it's maybe best to just take. He will probably take back with his h-pawn, but yeah. expect this particular move. But let's see, if I take, then he takes back with the knight, and my pawn is goes AWOL. He is probably thinking about dropping his knight into f4. It's okay if I take, he takes back, rook to d2, and he has nothing. So let's go for that. Okay, looks like I have a few users in the chat. So, welcome to any users, any viewers. I would rather get rid of this knight there, so. First, I would like to get rid of this annoying threat to my pawn on h2. And then we'll have to see what happens. Okay, castle's long. Sorry about this inconvenience. I did not mean to mess up my layout. Okay, he goes for the pawn. I have to take if I'm not going to lose my rook. But of course, I can't trap him either because he gets out either way there. So I'm already down a few pawns here. Not good at all. Quite a silly thing to do, really. Should have moved my bishop out of the way. But don't want to exchange too much material because that would be really bad for me. So about to lose a whole lot of pawns around here, so. This was a rather horrible miscalculation on my part. I'm going to lose probably both of my kingside pawns. Looking at this position here, so I will be down 4 pawns altogether. So this is, what can I say, a suicidal way of playing. But I don't have any choice. I have to take back there. So it doesn't seem to matter which way I go. Both of those pawns are going to be in the history books, but at least I will only be 1 pawn down, but I'm not sure if that's any consolation. Thanks, Uncle Vinny. I think I'm gonna have to do a lot better than what I'm doing right now, because otherwise, if I keep going at this rate, I will get my ass really seriously kicked. So. Yeah, I sure will try, Uncle Vinny. You bet. This is not very enjoyable as it is. Thanks, number man. I'm going to need all the luck in the world for this game, I think. Because nothing is looking good at the moment. So, he has secured a strong connection between his rooks there on the third rank. Yeah, I really regret having not played the advanced variation, but maybe I should have taken a page out of Mark Esserman's book from earlier this morning when he just went into the exchange variation, just took everything on in the center. And the only difference was that he was playing another guy who is way over 2400 online, and me and my opponent, we are nowhere near that. So let's see, what can we do, what to do? What to do indeed. Don't really fancy playing my knight into the corner. It looks like that might be the only place for it. Of course, I could support the pawn, but I can't see if that really does much. Maybe I should have brought my OTB board with me and had that on the side just to try to clarify the position, because often I'm completely oblivious to what I see on the computer screen. Let's see. Rook to h1. This is not a good position by any stretch of the imagination, but well, as old geezers have to keep fighting on, that's how it goes. Being three pawns down already, we just passed the 20 mo mark, and yeah, like I said before, my position is nothing to write home about. Yeah, that cramped positions can be reworked, fortunately, but my position is not really cramped. It's just horrible. So let's see. What in the world is he planning to do now? He must have seen something beyond what I can see. It's absolutely certain I'm gonna have to up the ante here if I want to have the slightest chance of getting anything back. Let's see, knight here, he might come here, king takes. Not a very pleasant position at all. But let's go for it. Knights are tricky, that's the only thing I know for sure. In my last game, we came out very quickly out of the blocks. Played pretty principled game for the most part, and around the 30 move mark, I had a chance to get myself into a winning position. It might have been around move 35 or something like that. I could have won a piece from my opponent, but I completely missed it. And what followed was a 50 move grind where my opponent finally was unlucky enough to give me a chance to trade off the queens. And that, of course, meant that my king was quick enough just to run away with just about anything on the board. Okay, he... That was a pretty sensible thing. Gets his rook out of the way there. So I think I have to get my king moving up the board. I have to try to find some counterplay here, because this is anything but easy. Yeah, that could be expected. I sort of understand why he is doubling up on the h file, but I wonder if he gains much by it. Of course he wants to exchange rooks, because that just makes his advantage that much more imposing. But let's see how we can maneuver here. Okay. Of course he wants to play some nasty tricks. No surprises there. Ooh, this, like before, looks bad, but I might have some options. Now I just have to wait and see what my opponent will do. But, I have to check if supper is already. So I'll be right back. Fortunately, my wife has a better grasp of time when it comes to cooking than me. So, supper did not get burnt to a crisp in the oven. It would be a travesty to burn lasagna. So that looks like it's the only thing I have to look forward to tonight. This knight here, he has found a rather annoying outpost there. So, of course, it can be kicked, but he has another outpost on f5 where he can make my life difficult. I don't really have any squares as outposts. Sort of a half chance on e5. But he only needs to move a pawn to kick me away. Let's see. It looks like my pawn can be a bit annoying where it is. So let's just wait and see. He's probably calculating some nasty line. He can't win that pawn outright, the f4 pawn, because it's so easy for me to just back it up on f2. But he might storm me on the king side. He has everything to do that. The only question is how he wants to start. Okay. He gets the king rolling. I think I'm gonna have to kick this knight. I don't like him in my position. He has a few options to play his knight now, but I think he will probably move back to e7. That seems to be the most logical place to go, because it's supporting the pawns on the king's side. But of course he might let greed get the better of him and try to attack my c4 pawn. He has knight to b6 to do that, but of course that's easily guarded by b3. I think I need more brain food here. Yeah. Fisherman's friend. And no sugar-free crap either. Because I need some brain fuel. The sweetener they use for the sugar-free products from this company is quite nasty. It's called sorbitol, and because I tend to go through a whole bag of this in a very short time, that could easily mean that I get a rather nasty case of diarrhea. Sorbitol is used as a laxative in many cases, so not very pleasant at all. Okay, this was unexpected. He's eyeing this square here. And if I move my king towards his knight, then he will probably check on h3 and kick me out. So I'm not going to make any hasty moves. Yeah, he will likely play his rook down to h4. That is a possibility. If I move my rook to f2, then of course he'll win the exchange without blinking, batting an eyelid. So of course I have a check here on c5. Which forks the queen, king and the pawn on b7, but of course he will just move his king to c7, and that means my attack is more or less in the wind. But in any case, he can't get to this e5 square from there. At least not right away. So let's go for that. Check. Yeah, exactly what I expected. probably attack my pawn again, or attack my knight. Of course, he doesn't want my knight to be anywhere near his king. To be extremely tricky if I'm going to stand any chance of getting anything out of this game, because my opponent is playing quite well. Much better than me in any case, so seems like I'm gonna have to go quite hard through some opening repertoire for the white side against the Caro Kann. See where I like the game the most. I quite fancy sharp lines, especially those gambit lines. That's why I, when I play against the Sicilian, I look for the sharpest openings possible. And I'm actually studying one now. I can hopefully get to use that in a game one day. We're gonna have to wait and see. Chess is a weird and wonderful game, and so many options. So many options of openings and tactics and strategies and all of that. When I started playing chess many, many years ago, I was always thinking, how in the world can I cause my opponent the most grief by playing a strategic game? And it didn't take me very long to find out that even playing disciplined games and lose, well, I thought when I started again in February, after almost 30 years of a pause, that, okay, if I'm going to lose, I might as well go down in a blaze of glory. So that's my approach to chess today. Just play the sharpest lines and try to just go down in flames rather than just whimpering in the corner. And I'm not really showing any sign of that in this particular game, I'm sorry to say. My opponent is very good at closing lines for me, so I have to gain space somehow, in some way. So let's see, what is he going to be up to now? Fortunately for me, my knight is extremely active in the middle of the board. My rook is keeping my second rank safe. But how long that will hold is anybody's guess. This was to be expected. I think my only defense is rook to f2. It's very unlikely that this will turn into a time scramble of any sort because of the increment. But still, 30 seconds might not be enough to find the best moves in case we get into a tricky end position. He takes with his knight, but if I push, then my knight is off. But I might just leave it. Take, he takes back. My rook is aiming for this, so I might want to play this. He will probably just storm his pawns. But I don't see any other options really in the position. So I think I will take. Oh, that was a dumb move to say the least. Well, I can just as well do this. Yeah, that was to be expected. Just have to get my king into the action. That's my only option of trying to stay in the game. Yeah, that was something I could expect. Because I had that move lined up if he had moved his knight. So I don't want him to check me with his knight. I have to try something. have to admire my opponent's tenacity there. He has played extremely well. Probably better than his rating suggests. But rating isn't everything. Even with my rating being 300 points higher than his, I haven't played anywhere near my rating. So he has earned being better by just outplaying me in every way today. Okay. He is not in the mood for letting me do any nasty business here. Play some kind of a prophylactic move, but what do I have? Don't think I have anything else. This was to be expected. Let's try check. Let's see if I check him here, he escapes. Let's try this. He's probably just going to kick me out of this square anyway. He's not. Okay. So rook is guarding a 6th rank admirably. to do. What to do indeed. Let's try this, see what he is planning. Oh, of course. So I don't have anything. My king is completely stuck. He has two pawns and a knight against those two pawns and a runaway pawn here. It looks bloody awful, to say the least. My only hope of saving is probably some kind of stalemating trick, but with this kind of a time control, there's absolutely no chance of him falling for something like that. So this is a question of if I have any tricks up my sleeve here. Any last ditch? No. I have nothing really. Let's try here. He's probably going to run his pawn up the board. This is resignable and was a long time ago, really. Yeah. I think I will just call it a night here, but this was bad from the very start. Yeah, this was not a treasure hunt for me at all. Yeah, this was absolutely horrible. And my opponent, he played much better than me, it has to be said. I completely screwed up everything from the start. So, e4, c6, takes, bishop f5. I just should have moved my knight right away. This was completely uncalled for to try this trap. But this trap is kind of funny, because if I get away with this and he plays here, then we have this. And I actually caught a player in the Rapid Shield Arena one Sunday a few weeks back. And actually I missed it the first time around when he played this knight to d7. I played bishop to f4, and he didn't spot the trap either, so he played knight to f6, and that was the move I was waiting for. So I caught him there, so it was this way. But still, this line with the queen e2, it's super dubious, and I got punished like I deserved. So that's how it goes. When you play badly, you can't expect any favors from your opposition. Your opponents, your opponent, he's never going to give you anything. You have to just earn everything yourself. But my opponent, he just kept on playing good moves. Queen d2. This is actually not such a bad move, even though the computer thinks it's inaccurate. Mainly because he has set up sort of a defensive line from the Scandinavian defense. But there, his bishop is usually all the way to g4, and this pawn is not pushed at all. And quite often black will trade his light squared bishop for a knight, even though the computer doesn't like that line. Unfortunately for me, I just kept on making bad move after a bad move. Knight g3 in this position here was just stupid. I was basically just thinking about getting rid of this light squared knight so I could go and castle queenside. But yeah, bishop f4 is probably a much better move. Yeah, so I played way too fast for my own good, and my opponent, he more or less punished me deservedly for that. I mean, I'm down a pawn there. Queen exchange isn't all that bad. So my opponent, he played reasonable move or moves all the way through. And taking the light squared bishop in hindsight, not a good idea. And all those moves, just normal moves. Long castle. I should have played my rook to g1. That was my original thinking. But unfortunately, I was hoping to get some kind of play in the center, but it never materialized. And like I said, my opponent, he played well, kicked my ass. I'm already, after this move, I am dead lost, because he just picks up everything and gets those pawns really easy. I never got any kind of playing going. And even if he was playing the odd inaccurate move, that did not make up for all of my mistakes. This was just a silly move. I would have been better off moving my king. But I was thinking, okay, if I move my knight here, then he will probably take with a rook. And I have nothing. And he's just gained a pawn. Even if I exchange and get one pawn back here, I'm just dead in the water. A knight against a knight and three pawns is just stone dead. But he got a piece for free there. I tried my best to get any sort of counterplay, but of course my king was. There was actually a little bit of a trap here. On move 38. If he had moved his knight anywhere, it doesn't really matter where. Let's say, just with the idea of, let's see here. Then he's mated. C5 would be a mate, so because he had locked himself in there. But the only save place for his knight to go would be to c5, but then I can kick it or win it back, because well, he can check me here and then he just gets out and there's no mate anymore. My rook is on. I might win this pawn back, but he is still just way ahead. But he played well. We don't even need to go any further in the analysis than this, because I'm dead lost from that point on, and it doesn't help when I blunder like rook h8. I had nothing really. I was thinking, is it possible to try to win his knight? But if I move my a pawn, he takes with a check and I'm dead regardless. So a harsh, harsh lesson in how not to play. I did everything wrong there. And my opponent capitalized on it and deservedly won. So, thank you for the match, jmhwsm. I think his name is Jeff, though I'm quite uncertain. He might actually correct me there someplace. But for my viewers, thank you for dropping in. I wish I could have cooked up something better, but unfortunately, I played like an ass. Plain and simple, and I got punished deservedly for that. And kudos to my opponent, he played an almost perfect game. Two inaccuracies, but I just kept on playing bad moves after bad moves and just easing his position as much as possible, and he just punished as I deserve to be punished. So again, thank you for dropping by, and I think I'm going to stop this stream now. Unfortunately, not my finest hour, but good night, everybody.